Thanks for tuning in. Today we shall be looking at some more examples on how we find effective resistors on series and parallel arranged resistors. For example, in this example, they're asking us to find the effective resistance above. So we have these two resistors, they are in series. These two resistors are in series with this combination. So it means that we need to first break down this so that we make it easier. We have these two resistors in series, and as since current is coming like this, this is in series with this. But these three resistors are in parallel because this current is coming, some of it is going there, there, there. So this whole thing is in series with that and in series with that. So let's first get the effective resistance here. The effective resistance in that parallel combination, let's call it 1 over R, is going to be equal to 1 over R1, which is 2, plus 1 over R2, which is 2, plus 1 over 4. So we end up with 1 over R giving us 5 over 4. So if we cross multiply, we make R the subject of the formula, we find that our value R is going to be equal to 4 over 5. And that is definitely equivalent to 0.8 ohms. So it means that this effective resistance is 0.8 ohms. It means our new diagram now becomes like this. It means we have simplified our diagram. These are 2 ohms connected to 3 ohms, and that is also connected to 0.8 ohms. This 0.8 ohms is the effective resistance of this. This 3 is that, and these 2 ohms are that. So now, they are now all in series. So now, meaning our effective resistance now, let's call it R0, is going to be equal to 2 ohms plus 3 ohms plus 0.8 ohms. And our answer there, 3 plus 2 is 5 plus 0.8 is giving us 5.8 ohms. So 5.8 ohms is the effective resistance of this entire combination. Let's do one more example. Find the effective resistance of this and that. We have two resistors here that are in parallel, but this parallel combination is in series with this. So for us to get the effective resistance, it means this resistance plus the effective resistance here. But since these two are in parallel, let's first get the effective resistance here. Effective resistance there, R, 1 over R is going to be equal to 1 over 2 plus 1 over 3. And here we shall end up with 1 over R, 1 over R is going to be equal to a half plus a third is going to give us 5 over 6. When we make R the subject of the formula, after cross multiplying, we get R as 6 over 5. R as 6 over 5 is definitely, in decimal point form, is going to be 1.2. So it means that our new diagram here is now going to become, the effective resistance of these two is 1.2. So this is 1.2. That's current flowing. Then the resistor there, 1.8, remains. Like that. So it means that we shall continue with our real resistance there for me being 1.2 plus 1.8. All this is in ohms. And our definite answer will be 3 ohms. So the effective resistance here is 3 ohms. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like and share this video. And for more videos, please subscribe. Please like our Facebook page at Kisembo Academy Video Tutorials, or follow us on Twitter at Kisembo Academy. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rangakuramia. Catch you in the next video.